Ladies and gentlemen, we've got someone special on the Reena D'Souza show. You have known him play different roles. He's a cricketer, he's an actor, he's a reality star. Welcome to the show. Thank you so much for taking time out and joining on the Reena D'Souza
show. Thank you very much, Reena. It's really great to be here. It's always nice to share your life with people, and especially at this time to get to know people also through this medium. So thank you, Reena, for having me.
Wonderful having you on board. I do know that Srisant has different roles in life. Tell us, in his childhood, how was Srisant?
No, I was never silent. Even though my name was Shant, my dad's name is Shant, my name is Shri. So, Shri is supposed to be the bright guy, you know, supposed to be everywhere. So, I was trying to be everywhere as a kid. And I remember in my childhood days, I used to make myself available for all these local matches. Let it be painting competition, let it be cricket match, let it be kabaddi, whatever possible way. I wanted to be always known in that locality, you know, something like that. And I wanted every youngster to feel that whatever they do, whether it's a girl or a boy, I don't know. I think that was in our blood. I was the last to be born in that generation. So I had my own privileges, and my grandmothers used to really make me the naughtiest, because they used to always support me. My sisters and my brothers, all my cousins used to get belted because of me. Cricket was introduced to me as a kid because I saw this wonderful game. They used to play with these coconut branches. So the coconut leaves ka bat banate the. So I used to be the ball picker. I was just the fielder. Throughout, I think, a couple of years, I was just a fielder, just searching for the ball in the forest, trying to get the ball back to them and helping them. So in Malayalam, they used to call me ball paruki.
That's a nice way of putting across. Tell me about your mindset when the news of the fixing came, the punishment came up, and how did you take that moment? Tell me all about it.
I can't shy away from saying, you know, I was depressed, very, very badly depressed. Now it's very easy to go back, but it was very difficult even to spend 1 minute. I think I was there for 12 days in the terrorist ward and special cell and all that. All the news came. So I just wanted to end my life. I'll be lying to myself if I say I was that strong at that point of time. I was destroyed. My elder brother had met me, and then he had told me, the only way you can prove everybody wrong and you right is staying alive. It was a very, very tough phase, and I was used to get interrogated almost 16 to 18 hours a day for the 12 days in a row. You know, when I started reading news every single day, and they were literally tearing me, not just me, tearing cricket, not just cricket, tearing my family, tearing my state, tearing my country. All these media was written about, even when it comes to the biggest of sports channels, they deleted me. Somehow they just edited me out of. So that was really disturbed. Everybody knew that I am disturbed. But so I had to make sure when I go into the room, I can do whatever I want. But when I get out of the room, I'm a son. I'm a brother. I had so many responsibilities outside the room. Inside the room, yes, I could be Srisant, who is depressed and disturbed. But I think the mindset at that point of time, there is no shyness in saying I wanted to give up. But then, when I met my mom and dad, I clearly remember when I hugged them, that was it for me. I think my mindset was giving attention to the small, small details. You know, I took it day by day, hour by hour, moment by moment. I kept on talking. It is very easy for everybody to be around you and motivate you. But if you don't self-motivate, or if you don't do the self-talk, everybody says, stay positive, half. And I think 90% of the people doesn't know what is positive. And people call it failure. Oh, I'm a failure. Or a failure has screwed me over. Forgive my language. But yeah, that's what they say. But then I say, there's no failure, there is no success. It's stupidity running behind success or worrying about the failure. It's a great experience. It's, you know, kyun dare zindagi mein kya hoga? Kuch na hoga to tajurba hoga. So it's all about experiences. Yes, compete with yourself. Be the best you. You know, every individual out there who's training hard wants to win. I think I'm just grateful to the Almighty. I think from the time I met my mom and dad, all I said to myself, I have to keep them happy. I have to show them the brave face. I have to make sure all my friends out there, family out there, whoever is supporting me has to be respected. The only way to do that is fight the battle. Always remember, life is a long, beautiful journey. Just because you don't do well in one thing in life, you should not give up. There is so many, especially this time, you can use the net well, wisely, use the 24 hours wisely, you can learn a lot. So that was my mindset. Just keep learning.
That's a wonderful answer. Honestly, from talking about being interrogated for so many hours and undergoing depression phase and saying what happened with your parents themselves, because they also had to go through what you were going, right? I can see a lot of positivity right now.